Have you ever wondered why a plant at a store looks so perfect with ample blooms, or how they get that large perfect apple? It could be because of plant growth regulators, PGRs. PGRs are widely used in many areas of agriculture today, including horticulture, pomology, oleariculture, ornamental horticulture, agronomy, turf grasses, and others. Although there is a lot of information in the scientific literature on the use of PGRs, it is not an exact science. To achieve the best results with PGRs, it's important to use a combination of art and science. It should be noted that PGRs are classified as pesticides. Therefore, they are subject to all of the same USDA record-keeping and worker protection standard rules as all pesticides. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video, I'll discuss practical uses of plant growth regulators in agriculture. A number of plant growth retardants are used in agriculture today for a variety of purposes, including arrest, bonsai, and cutlass, among others. The beneficial effects of plant growth retardants are more uniform and compact plants, better plant appearance, improved plant transplanting, improved shelf life, better capability to withstand stress, and in the case of turf grasses, reduced frequency of mowing and improved turf density, lateral shoot development, and turf color. Plant growth retardants reduce the size of plants by blocking gibberellin biosynthesis and, in some cases, gibberellin action. Retardants are applied as foliar sprays and soil drenches. Growers in warmer climates typically need to use higher rates and more applications due to the rapid stem elongation that occurs. More vigorous growing cultivars need higher rates and vice versa. Different cultural practices such as watering, fertilizing, and spacing together with temperature and light can affect the rate needed. The trade names for three commonly used ethylene-releasing compounds are proxy, florel, and ethryl. Proxy is used as a foliar spray to slow the growth of turf grasses, reducing mowing. Florel induces flowers in ornamental bromeliads, modifies sex expression of cucumbers and squash to facilitate hybrid seed production, and defoliates after buds have matured in roses and apple nursery stocks to allow digging of stock plants prior to bad weather. In azaleas, begonias, and several others, it increases lateral branching. In potted daffodils and hyacinths, it reduces plant height. Ethryl is used as a foliar spray to promote earlier coloration and maturity of tomatoes, grapes, apples, and peppers. It also promotes fruit abscission, also called slipping, in cantaloupes and accelerates blackberry ripening and loosening. The active ingredient in Retain is aminoethoxyvinyl glycine, which is a substance isolated from a soil microorganism that specifically inhibits the biosynthesis of ethylene in plant tissues. It has a number of benefits: improved harvest, reduced fruit drop, a wider window of growth to enhance fruit size and color, improved storage potential, and reduced variety of physiological disorders. Compounds that contain gibberellins have a variety of beneficial effects in plants and are used extensively in agriculture today. The trade names for these compounds are Rise Up, Release, Relax, ProGib, Gib Grow, and Provide. The beneficial effects include the capability to stimulate uniform germination and seedling emergence, the use of a thinning agent in stone fruits to improve fruit firmness, and the better shelf life and increased size during the season when they are applied. In seedless grapes, the gibberellins loosen the cluster and promote uniform size. In seeded grapes, they reduce berry shrivel and increase berry size. In addition, compounds containing gibberellins overcome dormancy, delay aging of the rind and citrus, thereby preventing physiological disorders, promote bolting and uniform seed production, and provide many other beneficial effects. Compounds containing auxins are used commercially for three main purposes: fruit thinning and sticking of fruits to trees, promoting adventitious rooting, and controlling weeds. Fruit thinning promotes better size, color, yield, and overall fruit quality. It also eliminates alternate bearing of fruits, which ensures that fruit load on trees is uniform year after year. Auxins also prevent fruits from prematurely falling off the tree, thus improving fruit quality. The four commonly used compounds containing auxins on the market that are commercially used for fruit thinning and sticking fruits to trees are Mid-Thin W, Fruit Tone N, Fruit Fix, and Citrus Fix. Three commonly used compounds containing auxins are used commercially to promote adventitious rooting: Dip and Grow, Rise Upon, and Hormidin. Containing indole 3-butyric acid, IBA, or naphthalene acetic acid, NAA. Many formulations of compounds containing the auxin 2,4-D are commercially available for the control of broadleaf weeds. Compounds containing gibberellins and cytokinins, such as Excel and Promelin, are used in agriculture for the many benefits associated with them. These compounds are used for fruit thinning, promoting elongation of apple fruit, and developing more prominent calyx lobes. In addition, they have been shown to increase lateral bud break, increase shoot growth, and improve branch angles on non-bearing trees used for nursery stock, which provides a better tree framework and earlier cropping. In conclusion, the major categories of plant growth regulators used in agriculture are plant growth retardants, ethylene-releasing compounds, an ethylene inhibitor, compounds containing gibberellins, compounds containing auxins, and compounds containing gibberellins and cytokinins. Plant growth regulators are used in agriculture today and have potential for use in the future.